Welcome viewers to the Fantasy Whiz coverage of the ICC Women's T20 World Cup. Today we are going to cover the 7th match of the competition, which is between 2018 runner-up England and debutants Thailand. Now this match will take place on 26 Feb at 9:30 AM Indian Standard Time. Now before we show you the Dream 11 team selection, we will have a look at the performance of both the teams so far in the tournament. We'll also have a small chat about the ground and pitch conditions, the weather update, the all important team news and also the probable lineups. Then we will discuss the key players for this match who should be part of your Dream 11 team. So guys, do stick around to catch our Dream 11 team combination for this match, which can make you win lots of prizes on Dream 11 or any other fantasy websites. Now let's start by having a look at the performance of both the teams in the World Cup so far. Now England were outdone by South Africa in their first match, with South Africa won easily by 6 wickets. Now apart from Natalie Skiver, who scored 50 of 41, other England players failed on the batting front. On the bowling front as well, Sophie Eccleston was the only pick of the England bowlers, picking up 2 wickets, and she did not get much support from the other end. As for Thailand, well, playing against West Indies was always going to be a difficult task, and that's how it turned out to be, as they were restricted to a moderate total of 78 runs in their 20 overs. But there was some encouragement for the Thai women, as they were able to restrict West Indies to 27 for 3 at one stage in the game, but eventually losing the game by 7 wickets. Now let's quickly take you through the 5 T20 matches of both these teams. Now in the last 5 T20 matches, England have won 2 out of their last 5, whereas Thailand have won 3 out of their last 5. But do remember, England registered these wins against the likes of Australia and India, whereas the only noticeable win for Thailand was against Ireland. Now a bit on the T20 history of this venue, the pitch conditions, and followed by the all important weather prediction. Now this match will be played at Manuka Oval, Canberra. Not many games have happened at this venue so far, so it's very difficult to comprehend how the pitch might play. But looking at the historical stats, it is traditionally a very good batting wicket. Now overall 5 T20 matches have happened on this ground, and 4 have been won by team batting first. Now the average first inning score is at 131, whereas that of second innings is 133. The highest score on this ground was 156 for 4, which was scored by England against Australia. Now this in fact happened in this very month, and Australia actually scored the same exact runs in a tied match, and England eventually won in a super over. Now the weather forecast for this match is not that encouraging. Scattered showers are expected in the morning with a 40% chance of rain during the match. Now let's quickly have a look at the team news, injury updates and probable changes. Now none of the players in both the teams faced any injury concerns, and so they definitely have a fully fit squad for this match. But considering that both have lost their first match, we can expect a change or two for both these teams. Now as for England, you know, Freya Davis or Maddie Villiers could easily come in for Lauren Winfield, who failed to contribute much in the match against South Africa. Also, both these players can also provide the 5th and 6th bowling option for England. As for Thailand, well, they could also ring in a change and give a chance to Fanita Maya, Suwano Kiato instead of Wong Paka, who has not been in good form of late. So here is our probable 11 for this match. Now as you can see, we have included the main players along with what we feel could be the probable changes. Now let's first have a list. Now let's first start with the listing the key players who should definitely be picked in your Dream 11 team. Now Amy Jones is a key player who can score runs at a brisk rate, and considering the opposition, she should be a good pick, as she can contribute as a wicket keeper as well. Now, as you can see, we have listed out the points that has been gained on the Dream 11 platform by these players. Now Skiver again, she had a very good outing in the match against South Africa, scoring a half century, and on the way she also hit 4 boundaries and a 6, and she seldomly bowls a quota of 4 overs. So she is a definite pick for this match. Heather Knight again is the captain of England team. She comes in 2 down and can bowl as well. and she will be eager to not only register their first win but also play a key role in that match. On the bowling front, as we mentioned earlier, Sophie Eccleston was a pick of the bowler, picking up 2 wickets. And not only that, her economy rate was below 5, so she can give additional points there as well. Now here you can see we have added Daniel Wyatt as a key player. Now despite failing to do much in the first match, but purely looking at her stats and importance to the team, she can play a similar role like Sklaver and can give points with bat and ball. Now moving on to Thailand, we have selected Buchatham as one of those players who can actually play a key role for Thailand. Now she comes or opens with the bat and also opens the bowling for Thailand. She is actually what Skiver is to England, and with the all-round capabilities, she has the potential to give more points. Now Nanapath, who is the wicketkeeper of Thailand, she again has been chosen purely on her performance against West Indies, where she actually alone contributed 42% of the runs scored by the entire Thailand team. And again, as we said, she is a wicketkeeper, so she can give crucial points via catch, run out and stumping as well. Now, Sulepon Laomi was the pick of the bowlers for Thailand and contributed 34 points in the first match. So she could be the only proper bowler that we think could be picked from the Thailand team. Now apart from that, we have listed out differential players as well. Now these players might not be part of the majority of the fantasy teams, but if they click, they would definitely give your team an edge to win most of the leagues. So as you can see, we have listed out Catherine Brandt, Anaya Shrubsole, Maddie Villiers, Suthir Wang, Chan Tham and Tipoch. Now let's jump to all important Dream 11 team selection. I will now show you a couple of team combinations for Dream 11 that a fantasy whiz team thinks can really win you some good points. Now although we have shown teams for Dream 11, our advice can be used on any platform to win big. Now England are odds on favorite for this match, so you should definitely have more players from their team. Now 6 to 7 players with a mix of batsmen, bowlers and all rounders would hold good. So considering this, we have gone with two combinations. Now the team winning the toss is likely to bat first, considering the history of this venue as we have shown before. So if England win the toss and bat first, then I will go with team 1. Now as you can see, in team 1 we have gone with Amy Jones as our vice captain and Skiver as our captain. Now we have already spoken about why we are going with these players, and Skiver has been in good form, so we have made her the captain and she can contribute with bowl as well. Amy Jones can give that fiery start, and hence we have selected as a vice captain. Now here again we have selected all the key players from England side who can contribute with bat and ball. On the Thailand side, we have tried to have players of all calibers with a mixture of all-rounders and batsmen. Now let's say if Thailand win the toss and bat first, then I will go with team 2. Now here again, the team 2 is again focused with a priority of England players. Again, Skiver is our captain here, but here we have gone with Eccleston as the vice captain. Now the primary reason is Thailand, even if they bat first, they might not score big. We saw what happened against West Indies, and even if they score a total around 100 or around that, it's very high chance that a top 3 of England side could easily score that number of runs. So hence we have gone with her as the vice captain. We have also taken Glenn as our third option for bowler. And here in Thailand we have tried to have a mix of batsmen and all-rounders. So that's it from our team fantasy wiz for now. All the best guys for this match, and hope you win big after following our tips. Please like our video and do comment if you want to share some feedback related to our video. We would really appreciate it. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more updates on other upcoming matches. Thank you and happy fantasying.